Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15.4 Beta 4 has been out for a few days. I've been using it full-time on my iPhone 13 Pro Max and my iPad Pro, and wanted to share with you my overall experience, any remaining bugs, and a few new changes and features that have been found since the What's New video. So I wanted to share that, as well as your experience based off the YouTube community poll, where there's 16,000 votes and 200 comments. I've looked at all of the comments, read them, and compiled a list as far as what's going on with the beta, whether it's super stable, or has additional bugs and more. But the first thing is a couple changes or features. If we go into settings and then we go to notifications, under notifications, there's a change here. So if we scroll all the way down, you'll see there's tracking notifications. This is a new icon here, and there's tracking notifications to do with Find My, and you can see all of them here. So you can additionally set this up individually now, where you had to go into Find My and sort of customize notifications based on that. They've changed it to this. Also within Find My, in the Me tab, they've updated it as well. So if we go into Find My, under Find My in the Me tab, you'll see here at the bottom, if you scroll down, it says customize Find My notifications and customize tracking notifications. They've updated this with more granular controls, so something a little bit different. Also, if you're in Canada and you use Apple News, Canada now has local news rolling out. So under news, if you're setting this up and using it for the first time in Canada, you'll now have the option for local news. That was something Apple updated this past week. Now, the overall experience of this update is quite good. It's been very stable for me. Performance and ProMotion seem to be excellent. So if we go over, although it did seem to not respond to my touch input there, but ProMotion and the smoothness of it seems to be great. And I've personally had no crashes or reboots. I haven't had that pink display issue myself. I'll talk about that in a moment. But overall, I've had a very stable experience. Apps may be a problem for some people as far as them crashing and things like that, but I personally have not had any issues with that. Cellular connectivity, though, is a little odd this time around. So you'll see currently I'm on 5G UC, but switching between that and 5G seems to be a little bit slower this time around. There was a modem update in this update, and for some reason, sometimes when I'm using music, it just sort of holds off for about 10 seconds or so, reconnects, and then works again. So this cellular switching thing must be trickier than we realize as far as the programming behind it and switching with these frequency updates. So hopefully they get this sorted soon, but right now it still seems to be a little bit problematic, and quite a few of you said the same thing. Now, Wi-Fi does appear to be better for most. So if you're using Wi-Fi and you are having issues, most people are saying it's better. There are a few people having issues with it dropping and things, but that could be related to a specific brand of router where maybe that needs an update as well. Oftentimes, Apple will update Wi-Fi, and in my years in the telecom industry, we saw this a lot where Cisco routers would just not work properly after an Apple update. So they wouldn't be able to kind of communicate with iPhones, and the Cisco routers would need an update, and they'd have to work with Apple to get that fixed. So there's some odd issues in this one for some people on specific routers. Thankfully, I haven't seen it on Unify devices or Ubiquiti devices, and it's working fine there. But maybe if you have Linksys or Cisco or something else, you may experience some issues. As far as Bluetooth, Bluetooth does seem to be working great for me, but not for everyone. So when I connect to my car, it uses the Tesla app to connect. It seems much, much faster this time around. When you walk up to the car, it'll automatically unlock. This time around, it's much faster. But for some people, when connecting to Bluetooth, it seems to be slower, specifically with AirPods. So let's give that a try. So we'll open up AirPods here, see how long it takes. Still hasn't connected. There we go. So maybe it's a little bit slower this time around, but for some people, it seems to be extremely slow, and then they lose their connection. So there's some issues here and there. Thankfully, I personally haven't seen too many, but that is a little bit slower than before. But for third-party apps, it seems to be better. Now, as far as battery life overall, it is a beta, and battery life can vary greatly. So if we go to battery life here, my battery health is at 100%, and I did a video about battery health with a ton of questions many people asked the other day, and so I definitely check that out if you wonder what battery health is, how it works, and all of that. But we'll take a look at the last 10 days. And yesterday, I had 5 hours and 2 minutes of screen on time, 5 hours and 54 minutes of screen off time. Now, one thing I've noticed a lot is mail is using a lot of background activity this time around. I've even had other people message me saying the exact same thing. Why this is, I'm not sure. I didn't change any mail settings or anything. However, it does seem to be a problem. You'll see that day I used almost, 65% of my battery, and I should be getting a little bit better life than that. This morning here, You'll see I've used it 44 minutes and 3 hours and 25 minutes of screen off time, and I've barely used the battery, maybe 10-15% at this point, and it's doing okay, but again, it's a beta and still has some issues, especially with those background issues, with mail specifically, and sometimes Twitter, but it seems to be using more power than it should. Now, Matt sent in his battery life on an iPhone 13, so I wanted to share that, and you'll see his screen on time a day or so ago was 2 hours and 33 minutes and 1 hour and 36 minutes of screen off time, with about using it a quarter of its battery, so 25%. Again, the next day or the day before, 2 hours and 43 minutes, 1 hour and 39 minutes of screen off time, and again, a quarter of the battery. However, he only charged it 2 hours ago, so that may play into the extended battery life there. So in order to get this to be very accurate, you need to not charge it pretty much from the time you wake up to the time you go to sleep and see what you get throughout the day. Or you could just have it run all the way down to see what you're getting total if you wanted to do that. Now, battery life on the iPad continues to be pretty poor. So on the iPad, if we take a look at it here, we go into settings, we'll go down to battery, give it just a moment, and you'll see now I'm already at 30%. Now, I was at 40% when I started this video, so it's draining quite fast, and it was last charged a couple days ago, and you'll see I've got a total of about 2 hours of screen on time, and then 6 hours and 11 minutes of screen off time. Find My is using a lot of background information, and I don't use this with the screen off ever, so there's some odd issue that continues to go on. I did try turning on low power mode, and it made a huge difference. It stopped all of that background activity, and I got all my battery life left or back, but I don't want to use low power mode, as that's really only designed to be used for when you need to get through the day and you don't have a charger nearby. So that's one of those things that I typically don't want to do, but it does seem to be nice and smooth, and I haven't had any crashes or anything like that. Now, I have had quite a few people say that the storage bug is actually resolved, so we'll check it here. I just booted this phone up, so we'll go to storage and see how fast it loads on the iPhone 11. So most people have messaged me saying that it's resolved in this update. Everything loads quickly. You saw it loaded pretty quickly there, system data and iOS. And so it looks like the storage bug has been fixed from beta 3 to beta 4. Any people that said it wasn't fixed before are saying that it's fixed now. So it definitely appears to be working properly. Now, there's been no mention of that pink or purple display and it rebooting. So that's a good sign. It seems like they fixed it in this update, although they haven't confirmed it. Hopefully we get a confirmation by the time the final version's out. And also the music bug does not necessarily appear to be fixed. So some people are saying that it's still causing a lot of background usage, the CPU is getting warm since it's using a lot of power, and of course it's using more battery because of that. So that's just sort of one of the side effects of that using a lot of CPU power. So hopefully they fix that streaming issue very soon. Maybe it has something to do with lossless, but we're not really sure. Now, as far as Apple CarPlay, this continues to have issues, and some people have even said once they plug in their phone, sometimes it won't work without rebooting their phone. So there's continued or ongoing issues, and it seems to be very different depending on which vehicle you use. So if you have a BMW, a Honda, Mercedes, a Ford, any of those different cars can cause different issues because they're all using sort of their own stereos. So they may need updates, but that's not as easy to do as update the phone. So hopefully Apple can resolve this quickly. As far as remaining bugs, some people are saying the apps are freezing or crashing. I did hear from a few people that said WhatsApp is having a problem and it's crashing over and over. So Apple has changed something in 15.4 that probably WhatsApp needs an app update or maybe will be resolved by the time it's released to the public. So we don't really know 100%. And then a lot of people are having issues with the App Store just not connecting properly. So you go into the App Store, you'll get a message, it doesn't connect, and you have to try it again and then it works. So that seems to be a pretty common thing. And then as far as remaining bugs, the last one is with VoiceOver on, Siri will actually repeat itself twice for some people. So I heard this from a couple people. So if you're asking it something and you have VoiceOver turned on, it just repeats itself. So it seems to be a little bug in the code. As far as overall performance, well, I already mentioned that it's quite smooth on my 13 Pro Max, and it doesn't really matter what device you're using. It does seem to be pretty smooth overall, whether it be an iPhone 10 or something else. So ProMotion is good on the newer devices, but overall performance is good here. Of course, I don't have an internet connection. I'm in the middle of nowhere, and I'm not using a hotspot. So you'll see it's quite smooth as far as scrolling, and different applications seem to work just fine. Of course, like I said, there's no connection here, so it's not going to work there. But if we go into settings and scroll, it seems to be fine. So no issues with performance. As far as benchmarks, I did mention in the What's New video that I would run benchmarks and then share those with you after a few days, and I did do that. And we'll take a look here. We'll go to CPU, or history, CPU, and you'll see on February 25th, I actually ran it again and scored 1,730 for single core, 4,757 for multi-core. That's on the 13 Pro Max. So you can see here that the single core is a little bit lower by 4, but the multi-core score is higher. And so that's a great sign. It's over 100 points higher, and the overall performance seems to be fine and match that. We're within range that you really shouldn't notice a difference if it's about 100 either direction. So it works quite good, and that explains why it's super smooth and fast. Now, as far as the benchmark scores on the other phones, I wanted to share that as well. So again, I ran the benchmarks on the iPhone 11 and iPhone 10, and you can see on the 11, it is 1,320 for single core, 2,415 for multi-core. On the iPhone 10, it's 903 for single core and 1,888 for multi-core. So it's doing just fine compared to what it was before, and should be performing like it was or better. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15.4 Beta 4? Well, if you're already on one of the betas, you should install it without question pretty much. The reason for that is you're testing betas, you need to find the latest bugs after they've updated, and then report them in feedback. However, if you're not a beta tester, I'd probably hold off at this point until the final release. So make sure you're submitting feedback. In fact, I have someone that regularly messages me that submits a ton of feedback, and oftentimes Apple will get back to them and work with them to figure out what the problem is, and then they'll see that issue resolved. So that happens quite a bit if you submit a lot of feedback or feedback and they've have some questions about it. You'll often see them work on those issues based off of priority, if it's major or not. Now, as far as iOS 15.3.2, I thought for a while maybe we'd see that, but now that we're getting closer to a final release of 15.4, I'm not so sure we'll see that. Based on what we have here, I think we're going to see a release candidate of 15.4 in the first week of March with a final release around the 8th. We expect an Apple event on the 8th, and so I don't think we'll see a 15.3.2, but it is possible this week that they could do that to address security issues and bugs. But typically, since we're so close to 15.4, they'll probably just hold off till that. But again, Apple changes things up a lot, so maybe we'll see something like that. As far as 15.4, like I said, the RC, and then probably the final around the week of the 8th or March 8th or so. And we should expect Apple invites to go out probably this coming week as well, if there's going to be an event on the 8th. If there's an event on the 8th, many people expect new Macs, that new iPhone SE 3, and probably a new iPad Air. So we should see all of those very soon, and hopefully we'll see invites this week. And if we do, of course, I'll be sure to let you know. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the YouTube community poll and some of the comments. And as you can see, it says 22% of you are on 15.4 Beta 4, 66% of you are on 15.3.1, 2% are on 14.8.1, 1% are on 13.7 or older, and 9% of you are on Android. So thanks to everyone that actually voted in the poll and commented. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of your comments. So just like last week, I thought I'd go over the comments face to face, maybe change it up a little bit, and I've picked some randomly just as I was going through all the different comments. And the first one is from Mel Harris. It says 15.4 Beta 4, iPhone 12 mini has been good, battery life is better than Beta 3, very smooth, no reboots or crashes, everything works. On my iPad 12 Pro, again, very good. Battery life is not great, but battery life hasn't been good on that iPad for a while. Smooth and fast, no complaints there. And again, like I said, on my iPad, if I turn on low power mode, it goes right back to normal. So that mail app and other things seem to be using a lot of power for some reason. Christina Viram says, I'm on 15.4 Beta 4 on my 11 Pro Max, and it's running great. Battery life is almost back to normal. Real Players says, I'm on 15.4 Beta 4 using iPhone 13. Everything is running great and battery life is amazing. I'm getting around 7 to 12 hours of screen on time. I'd be curious if you're actually plugging that in during that screen on time or if that's actually from 0 or 100% down to 0. Danny Avalos says, both Beta 4 and 15.3.1 still have really bad battery drain and overheating issues. I'm convinced Apple is doing this on purpose. Well, I would say there's something going on your device specifically. If it's having overheating, well, technically they don't overheat, they get warm, and then Apple kind of throttles it and pulls the heat down that way. But really, they don't change this. It seems to be getting better with beta 4, so I would definitely check out some of your apps. One thing I've seen is Facebook will use a ton of power, and until they update their apps, they continue to do those things. So look at your apps, see what they're actually using, and most people are saying they're getting better battery life, so there's definitely something going on specifically on that phone. Cameron Applefan says, using iOS 15.4 beta 4 on my 13 Pro Max, so far I will say battery life is better than 15.3.1 public release. Also, more apps are smoother for me since it can take advantage of 120 Hertz and performance is faster. I have zero complaints on 15.4 beta 4. Keep up the awesome content. I enjoy them all. Love your videos. And thank you for that. HK the Fun Side says, iOS 15.4 beta 4 on my iPhone 13 Pro. Performance is good. I believe battery life was good in beta 3 and beta 4, some battery drain. Overall, no bugs, runs smooth. Nexus says, I'm using iOS 15.4 beta 4 on my iPhone 11 and iPhone SE first generation, and it's great. Performance is great, everything feels super fast and smooth, and battery life seems to be even better than 15.3 was. The issue where the storage takes a while to load has definitely been fixed in 15.4. It loads right away for me now, even in low power mode. Jose Adorno says, using 15.4 beta 4 on a 12 Pro Max, pretty good so far. iPadOS 15.4 beta 4 has not been kind to my 9th gen. Battery is pretty bad, just got it last week, so it's brand new. And like I said, something's up with that iPad, so hopefully they fix it with a software update. Hopefully 15.4 resolves it. I know about 15.2 it seemed to improve, and then once we got to 15.3 betas, it just went bad again. So there's something going on in the background that I hope they resolve very soon. Karen Liz Henriquez says, it's going good. Good quality and battery, I'm on 15.4. Marley Allen said, my LTE and 5G have been hit and miss since beta 4. I constantly get pages not loading and drops with the internet connection. iPhone 12 Pro Max, iOS 15.4 beta 4. And like I said, the connection for me has been odd as well when I'm switching between different versions of connections. So LTE, which is 4G or 4G and 5G, there's some odd issues there where it just sort of drops and then works again. I'm not sure what that is and why it takes a while, but there's some switching going on that's hopefully improved with a software update. Noodle said, had to reboot after my iPhone got a little warm because Mail.app decided to use 60% of my battery. Seems fine now. And so like I said, Mail is causing a lot of issues for a lot of people. So maybe it has to do with iCloud Plus and some of those features? I'm not really sure. Archie said, most stable version so far, battery life is great and performance is smooth and fast. Had no bugs or crashes. And so that's everything for iOS 15.4 beta 4. Some nice little feature updates and changes, but not a whole lot. As we get closer and closer to a final release, there'll be more and more refinement. But if you find anything more in this update that I haven't mentioned in any of my videos, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, we're waiting for that Apple event as well. So if we get an invite this coming week, I'll be sure to let you know about that as well. Expect an RC this week and a final release very soon. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.